I'm Audrey too, your best friend, or your worst nightmare. You choose. Now, before we get it and feed me, I got a few announcements. Listen up. Yes, you, Mr. In the Middle, Roe J, pay attention. First, this is Skid Row, not Levittown. There's no cell service anywhere, so please, turn off your phones. No, really, turn them off. I put them all on airplane mode. Those phones really interfere with our sound system, so if you can't hear anyone up on this stage, it's because of you. Two, do not record any of the performances. You will be breaking copyright laws, and I ain't about to go to jail because you up here trying to get your videos on your Facebook. Now, number three, you never know when a fire accident can occur, so lift up your head and look out for those nearest exits. Four, the only one getting fed tonight in this joint is me. We want to keep it nice and clean, so don't be bringing any of your sodas or potato chips or M&Ms in here, unless you plan on sharing it with me. Proceed at your own risk, child. Now listen, we encourage you to support our musical program by buying some snacks at the concession stand. The food isn't sloppy. Just eat in the hall, and no matter what they offer you, don't feed the plants, unless it's me, of course. Last, tonight's show will feature some special effects lighting and special effect gas. Now don't worry about no nitrous oxide though. Orin's sucking up all that good stuff himself. This show got some mature content too, including some explicit language, mainly from yours truly. Some light moments of violence and some heavy important themes like getting everything your greedy heart desires. Don't think this show ain't about you. Now, on behalf of the Woodbridge Senior High School Performing Arts Department and the company of Little Shop of Horrors, we welcome you to Skid Row.
Recorded, so we ask that the audience please remain silent, silence your cell phones, and make minimal disturbance as the show is being professionally recorded. Thank you.
On the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this enemy appeared seemingly in the most innocent and unusual of places.
Little shop of horrors. now, Seymour?
Nothing, Mr. Mushnick.
Run, similar. So she finally decides to come to work.
Good morning, Mr. Mushnick.
What morning? It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, have we had any customers? Who has customers when you were in a flower shop on Skid Row?
I'm sorry.
Seymour, what is going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey, wait. Where did you get that, Shiner?
Shiner? What on earth are you talking about? There's nothing there. Nothing there.
Audrey, that greasy boyfriend of yours, he's been beating on you again? Look, I know it may not be any of my business, but I'm starting to think he might not be such a nice boy.
Oh, well, you don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick.
I got the special part of you, Mr. Wong!
Seymour, look what you've done to the inventory!
Don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick!
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I guess we lost those parts.
I'll
give you plenty of time, right? Good God, what an existence I had. Misfit employees. No bums on the sidewalk. Business is lousy. My life is a living hell. Hey! You three are out the stew. That ain't bad enough. I got wireless permanently decorated the block and these three worthless ragamuffins to complete the picture.
Oh, we ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Ronette.
You ought to be in school.
We're on the split shift.
Right. We went to school till about fifth grade, then we split.
So how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better ourselves? Mister, when you're from Skid Row, there's no such thing.
Yeah.
It's just status quo. Constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone tell me my shot or I'll rot here. Show me how and I will, I'll get out of here. I'll start climbing uphill and get out of here. Someone say I'll get out of here. Someone tell me you're wrong that I'm stuck.
From another world. And when the light came back, this weird plant was just sitting there.
2095.
I know what made you.
that. Well, I guess a few drops could hurt. As long as you don't make a habit out of it or anything.
Happy.
Sam is out.
Sorry, gonna show you that.
One day I'm speaking. Am I late? Did I miss it?
Sure, I sure did.
Oh, Seymour's first radio broadcast. I tried to be on time,
but
don't tell me.
You got tied up.
No, just handcuffed a little.
Girl, I don't know who this mess is you're hanging out with, but he is
hazardous to your health.
That's for sure, but I can't leave him.
Well, why not?
He'd get angry. And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd have to do if he ever got mad.
So dump the chump, honey. Get another guy. Let him protect you.
Mm-hmm. And we got one all picked out.
A little botanical genius.
And she's not talking about George Washington Carver. Seymour?
Bingo!
Oh, I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a past.
Please, and who wants to get this job?
I don't deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
This child said this from low self-image.
You had a heart.
She had a problem.
I know Seymour is the greatest, but I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black guy in my arms and a kiss. Still, that Seymour's a cutie. Yeah. But the cat, he's got it a beauty. And I dream of a place where we could be together. At last.
And what kind of place is that? An emergency room?
Oh, no! It's just a daydream of mine. A little development I dreamed of, just off the interstate. Not fancy like Levittown. Just a little street in a little suburb, far, far from urban Skid Row. The sweetest, greenest place, where everybody has the same little lawn out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty because they all look just alike. Oh, dream about it all the time. Just me and the toaster and a sweet little guy like Seymour. A matchbox of a fence of real chain link.
Stick on the furniture.
I'm not a
I hear the shot, I hear the, hey, this must be that plant they're talking about in the news. What'd you call it?
An Audrey 2.
Ah, nice name. Catchy. Cute plant. Big.
Thank you. I raised it myself. Well, now if you don't mind,
like, ain't they saying that this is some sort of new species or something?
That's what they tell me, but please, sir, it's close as it shows.
Oh, it's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend, Seymour Orange Scrabella. A DDS.
When you say you raise this thing, right?
Right.
Well, I sure as hell would keep down this girl, girl, dump like this. This big lava cloud here, this is a ticket to the stars. Take to any forest out of town and name your price. Hell, somebody has to make your goddamn partner to get their hands on this.
Well, I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
No, excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. I'm telling you, kid, this big old green thing is a gold mine. Get your ass out of here and take the plane with you.
What?
Wish the next girl flourish fat. It's like a joke. You hear me talking?
I hear you.
Shouldn't we be leaving now? I'm sorry.
Sorry what?
I'm sorry, doctor. I'm sorry, doctor.
Gotta turn a nest, huh? Well, my bike's outside in Double Park, but you think about what I said, Scout. I mean it. You think about it.
Sure, I'll think about it.
You do that. Audrey, you got the handcuffs?
You're right, it might be accurate.
Then let's go. You'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick. You should hear the way he talks to Audrey.
Oh, God, then he won't know the kitchen's anymore.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy. It's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me here, why did I be right before I started with this?
Father, sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, a sadistic creep like him.
Who's the main friend?
What a louse.
I said be funneled and be wrapped. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
To be my son? Would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, but count the cats, it's in the drawer. I've got no choice unless you force say yes.
Or,
Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you loved the scent, but now I see that you're a lynch. I'm proposing to be my son. Mushnick and son! Sounds great. Three worlds, a string of fate. So sail and cooperate with me. A forest dream come true. Mushnick and his boy, Jiggy Lou. What business will do for FTD? That is, he will be my son. I'll get my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnick, don't be rash. You always said that I was trash.
I was joking.
I'm joking.
Use the physical expression of my pride, of the sweet maternal mistress I held pent up inside.
Yeah.
million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia. Mushnik's taken a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Batui, who cares if we've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? So what if I've had a few dizzy spells? A little lightheadedness. It's been worth it, old pal. Well, look, I'm gonna run down to the corner, pick up some nice chops, so I'll see you later. Oh. Oh boy, here we go again. Look, Tui, I haven't got much left. Just let me heal a few more days, and it will start again on the left hand, and see me! I beg your pardon? Feed me! Tui, you talked! You opened up your trap, your thing, and you said,
feed me, Krellborn, feed me now.
Well, I can't.
I'm starving!
Oh boy, look, maybe we can squeeze a little out of this one, but...
I need some food! More! More!
But there isn't any more. What do you want me to do, slip my wrists? Like I said, I'm gonna run down to the corner and pick up some nice chopped sirloin.
Must be blood.
Tui, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me!
Does it have to be human?
Feed me!
Does it have to be mom?
Feed me!
Where am I supposed to get it?
Feed the Seymour. Feed me all night long. That's right, boy!
Out for caring me, I'm all by the planet.
job and fed to 100 plants.
So you do.
Stupid woman! Crap! Freaking stutter brain!
Sorry, Doctor! I'm sorry, Doctor!
Now get the hell out of here! Get that damn sweater, you dizzy cow!
Yes, Doctor! Right away, Doctor! Yes, you are!
Come on, move it, you little slut! Hey, like a stupid dame! Bring in the freaking sweater! Bring some stupid hat with food on!
Lauren, that hurt!
Move it!
Can't get it off! Well, don't just sit there, Seymour. Give me a hand, will you?
Well?
He says, well. Oh, Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should get in like a sappy, happy dog. It's just a gas. It's got me high.
Feed me!
her in the morning.
Sorry.
don't you, Mr. Daddy, me, Eleanor? Audrey, darling, perhaps you would leave me and Seymour alone for a minute to have a chat. Maybe you'd like to go visit your dentist friend.
Well, that's not very funny, Pops. You know he disappeared.
That's right. He did, didn't he? Excuse me, boy chick.
Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
Audrey, why don't you run along like I told you to? I'll catch up with you. I'll call you if that's all right.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushneck.
Little red dots all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Pops.
Oh, I've had a pretty strange afternoon, son. You see, after my appointment with the lawyers, I got called down to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they decided to perform a routine investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. You want to know what they found? A Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office!
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked, Seymour. And then I began to think of all the strange little occurrences I've noticed around here. For example, little red dots all over the linoleum.
Oh, I spilled some Hawaiian punch on the floor.
Hard to keep things clean around here. Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
Where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
He's got your number now.
I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
It was just what you done.
The little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You've got no place to hide.
But then, I've had your kiss in the dentist girlfriend.
You've got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
Who knows your life of
crime?
I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent!
How do you explain this?
A picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap. It seems the police found it in Scarbello's office, showed it to me, asked if I could identify it.
Did you?
No, not at all. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. You know something else? They don't know about the dots, the uniform, the girlfriend.
I didn't do it!
Then come with me to the police and tell them that! Just so my dear Audrey's
you know he's on your trail.
card in there. What is inside the plate?
I don't see it. Where is it?
It's in there.
Seymour?
Represent you. We want to book you on back street doors.
gonna do?
My future's starting, I've got to let it stick with that planting gene, my bank account will fry. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant alive. I take these offers, that means more killing. Who knew success would come with messy, nasty dreams? I sign this contract, that means I'm willing to keep on doing what it offers.
Right. Let's snap the photo. We'll be famous. I'll take that teenage job. We'll live a nice quiet life. away from here, and once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I'll take you to that little development you've always dreamed about. Nice little house, nice little car, and no plants, no plants at all.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
Just go home now, Archie, please.
I can't leave you in this condition, I won't.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything. Feed me. Under no circumstances.
Feed me.
I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me.
Oh, I can't do this anymore. Look, I'll run down to the corner and pick up a pound of rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you till Life magazine.
No way.
Look, it's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done. Fine, great. And don't think you're getting dessert.
I couldn't sleep. I took a Sonnex, but the voices in my head kept saying, go to Seymour, talk to Seymour. I drank some tea, but gee, the feeling wasn't gone. Seymour, sweetheart, tell me, darling, what's been going on?
Lady,
hello. Who said that?
You're looking cute.
Somebody in here?
You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour!
No, it ain't Seymour. It's me.
Oh my God!
Your friendly Audrey, too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe this!
Believe it, baby! It talks!
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither. Relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, would you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need some water. In the worst way. Look at my branches. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I don't know if I should.
Hey, little lady, be nice.
You just want water, right?
Sure do, I'll drink. Don't die, please.
You know, the plant said the strangest thing just now. It said that Arn and Mr. Mushroom were already inside.
It's true. I did it. I fed them to it.
Is that what made it so big and strong? And you so famous?
I've done terrible things, but not to you. Never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, feed me to the plant.
You don't know what you're talking
about. Oh, I do. It's the one gift I can give you. So, if I'm in the plant, then I'm part of the plant. So, in a way, we'll always be together.
No.
Mr. Norton, who works right there.
Ah, thanks, sweetheart. Here's something pretty cool. Alright. Crowball. Ah! Seymour Crowball!
Leave me alone.
Patrick Mott, Licensing and Marketing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you, boy.
I'm not interested.
It's just a simple licensing deal. We take leaf cuttings, develop little Audrey 2s, and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America could have one. Now, I got some boys waiting outside ready to take cuttings. We could start collecting now if you don't mind. Hey, imagine, boy. Audrey 2s everywhere. Why, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops? Much bigger. Every household in America. Thousands of you eating. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it? No shit, Sherlock. We're not talking about 100 plants here. We're talking about little conquests. Feed me! You're the only thing I ever loved. Too bad! Take that!
That looks like enough. I think we should get going. Open up the van, boys. We're ready to start loading.
Eventually.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, hi. Okay. Hi, everyone. We really appreciate all of you coming out tonight to watch these amazing, wonderful actors. They've put so much into the show and have worked so hard to make the show happen, but it wouldn't be complete without our seniors, so let's give them a round of applause. One senior I would like to honor the most tonight is Miss Sydney Bales. Tonight, Sydney went out of her way to conduct the pit, and it was her first time ever, so let's give her a round of applause. Yeah. We also want to give another round of applause to our lovely pit, because this show would not be possible without them. Yeah. Alright, so every closing night, we do a short rose ceremony, in honor of in honor of our seniors in the show. For this ceremony, a junior will give a senior a rose of their choice. So, go ahead and give your roses to your seniors, guys. This rose symbolizes a legacy that the seniors have left behind, a small yet unforgettable memento of their past. Us underclassmen have learned to cherish each memory we have made with the seniors. And we will never forget what they've done for us. They've helped us grow and learn. They've held our hands through every struggle. They've set great examples for us, but mostly and importantly, they've set a legacy for us to continue. So while they're off thriving the scary adult world, doing incredible things, we stay here. And we stay to continue their legacy, what they have worked so hard for, and we love them. And we are very excited what the future brings for them. So, good job, students.